Well, good morning, boys and girls of the internet. Hope everybody's having a fantastic day out there. Happy holidays to you and all that jazz. That being said, let's just go ahead and do this thing today. I went and cleaned out the garage a little bit, and in the back I found this SaltDogg spreader that I bought a couple years ago. Got a really good deal on it because it had some broken pieces, and I never bothered to use it. I had the tractor to push snow when it does happen, and that's all I ever really worried about. This is just kind of an impulse buy, and I haven't used one of these big salt spreaders before that go behind the truck, but I think maybe this year we'll give it a shot. So first of all, we've got to put it together and see what was broken. Being as it's been a few years, I'm pretty sure I have all the pieces, just one of them was broken. So here is the main attachment doodad thing here. We've got a little electric motor, a little bit of rust on that shaft there, but it spins, keyway's still in it. All this was bolted together when I got it. I've got the lid for it, and here's the jug or the container itself, and inside we've got a slew of new parts still in the bag. I did cut it open. Got some electrical wiring, quick connectors, battery terminal connectors. That's not poop, it's dirt. So we had a bunch of torrential flooding. So we had a warm couple days that just came out of nowhere. I mean, unseasonably warm weather. And with that, we had some torrential rains. A couple days nonstop, day and night of rain. And the garage has a dirt floor in it. And even though it's pretty dry normally, it flooded everything in there. Luckily, the only part that was actually sitting on the ground was the end of the container. Bag of hardware, never been opened. Looks like it has the rubber fasteners and stuff in here, because I do know, you can see these little holes here. The lid attaches to the top with these rubber clamps. We've got some plates. More bracketry. This is the part that actually goes in the slot, sleeve hitch on your pickup truck or SUV or tractor, whatever you're hauling it with. And then this mounts into that. And it looks like you've got a couple of different positions, so it's adjustable up and down. Ah, here we go. There's a broken piece. So this said buyers on it originally. I think that's the piece that goes on the hub or the electric motor itself and rotates around to fling all your salt. Got a, let's see, SaltDogg. Ah, even got a piece of paper. It's very damp. Showing you how to connect all the electric stuff together. So we'll put that in the house to dry out. 8 of 2016, so this unit's, 9 years old, almost? Vibrator, blast, oh. All right, so there's the controller. And then the guard, looks like that tab slightly bent. Like I said, it's been bouncing around in the garage for quite a while. I don't see an instruction manual for all the hardware though. Let me go back, look in the build and see if maybe I just overlooked it. Check it out. So after digging around, around the torque converter, I found this in the dirt. This is some kind of auger and quite possibly a piece that we're missing. I don't know for sure. Yeah, I don't know if that's actually part of it or not. But then I also found, look at that. It's damp, but we found it. I needed a workbench, but I'm going to put it on this Dodge. So I just took the tailgate off so that I could still have a workbench. Instructions are pretty straightforward. Went ahead and slid it in the receiver. I've got the quick release pin in. As you can see, the bolt is not in the bottom. So it's sitting at an angle. Looks pretty straightforward though. I went ahead and mounted this up, this little guard to keep it from blowing back on the truck. I'm going to use this one because this Dodge is a native of West Virginia and she is not in good shape. So I'm not too worried about this one should I get the chance to use it like I plan. What else? I guess let's move on to some more steps until we can't get any further because of the gear. So Charlie was right. This little dude right here is, of course, the impeller that runs up into the barrel to spin it to make sure the salt doesn't jam. That nut or that bolt going through it is where the prop hooks up. And you just turn this until it falls in place and then you tighten down that little set screw. So pretty convenient little setup. Now the drum, you see it's got this cut in it right here. This is so when you set it, like that, it falls against this, which lines up with those holes right there that go through the drum. See my finger right there? Yeah. And then you take this plate, put over the back of it, take these long bolts and some big washers, and bolt this to the spreader or to the frame. I already misread the instructions. So I figured it out now, but you take one of these small washers, like so. And I had doubled up for some reason. I thought it needed a small one and a big one on the same side, but it doesn't. It's just one small one, just like this, through the inside. Shake, rattle, and roll until it comes through. Take one of your big boy washers, put it on the outside, and then you nut. Voila. Because I was reading that all wrong. So I got it figured out now. You can see here like that. With all those tightened down, probably in the wrong orientation, I'm sure this is the part where if you're feeling like it, jump down in the comments and tell me where we went wrong. Otherwise, you know, I'm just going to keep on going. Take the big bolt. That's what's going to keep this thing sitting pretty much upright. And keep in mind, you have multiple holes in the slide portion of the receiver to go further into the truck. And, you know, the further in you go, the more you get the slide in, the more straight up and down it'll sit. But that's pretty decent. Keep in mind, the salt's heavy too. But, I mean, can't be too heavy, but we need to install these pieces here so that we can attach the lid permanently. There are no washers left at this point, which leads me to believe we don't need any. That's what I'm assuming anyway. They'd have given me some if they wanted me to use it. One down. Let's do the other side. I just noticed this. I don't know what this is from. There's like a big old dent or an outward dent in the plastic. I don't remember if that was there 2 years ago, or maybe that's why the auger was broken. Maybe it was dropped during transit or something, but it's protruding outwards. But not the end of the world. Oh, gross. Charlie's, I've got his runner hooked to our swing on the front steps, and he went to take off, and when he did, it pulled the swing, and water poured out of one of the poles. There we go. And here's the dirty lid. Sits over it like that. And then we've got two holes here. They're made for these brackets going. Check out the pocket knife. I got wheel core open assist. I never bought any real expensive knives. I got this one as a gift. It's gonna go there, and then you'll pull it down over that, and that's what'll keep her latched into place. But I bet it goes that way, right? Yeah, that would make more sense than that sticking out, huh? That's right. And that'll also keep it down into the position you need if you're just doing it the other way. Yeah. Okay. Moment of truth. That side latched in. A tight fit. I don't know if it's supposed to be that tight or not. I mean, it's on there. Sure as heck ain't coming off. That was... That was tight. Almost looks like the bolts that are going in are pressed up against the inside of the plastic in there. But that is the... Yeah. That's the orientation in which they told me to put them. So, I don't know. That's how it's said to do it, but that just seems like it's pushing a lot. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, you see? The screws right there are pushing into the plastic. It's like it would make more sense if the screws came out the other way. Yeah, see, look, they're gouging. They're gouging into the plastic. All the little screws were the same length, though. Yeah, see, look, that side, too, is just cutting right into it. Let's turn those around. I flipped all the screws around. Let's see if that makes the difference we were looking for. Oh, yeah. Look at that. That just sits better. So they want those bolts going through the opposite way, but if you do that, it rubs the inside of this really bad, and I bet it's going to eventually wear grooves in it. I like that a lot. And I just gotta tighten up that big bolt down there on the bottom. Found a pipe wrench. Nice old rusty one. Got it tightened down. Guess it's time we jump on the old internet and see if we can't figure out what that what this piece is called that we're missing. I know it's the spinner and this bolt right here that runs through it. You can tell it had a cutout in it for that to go, so it would have held it on and held it up into place. So we'll just need to figure out. Maybe if the old jungle website sells them, that'd be really nice. Get it for cheap. We can go ahead and maybe test out the electronics, make sure the motor still works. I'm not going to wire it to the truck today. We're losing daylight, temperature's dropping. But what I can do, plug the motor into the controller. Plug the controller hopefully into my jump box and power this thing up just enough to make sure it still works. Probably should have done that before we put all this crap together, huh? Got some sad news. All the connections are actually really well made. All the quick connectors are in really nice watertight looms, or watertight grommets in between all the connections. It's got these nice caps you put over it if you're taking this thing off and putting it into storage. I really like all of this, including the harness that comes off the truck. It's got caps for you to put over this if you tuck them back up underneath your bumper, you know, because who's going to be unwiring this every year? Anyway, sad thing though is I saw some extra wires and some stuff like that and some extra connections that I couldn't use. As it turns out, mine doesn't have a vibrator made into it. I got to looking on the schematic, that's an option. It's a separate motor that's not attached to this guy, so can't play with a vibrator. But what we can do is hook this up, like I mentioned, to our jump box and see if we can power it on. So if you don't know what you're looking at, that is my JNC 77770R. It's a very old unit. It's over, I think, 5 years old now, at least. Original battery, original equipment in it. Everything still works, and it works pretty well. It still holds a good charge. I actually melted the leads off the end of it, jump-starting a few big diesel trucks, which that one's not recommended for the big, big diesel trucks, but I did it anyway. And it worked, but the leads got so hot, I started melting ends off it. So those are replacement clamps. However, the rest of it is original. So kick that thing on, 12.6 volts. Here's our spreader control. Let's flip the power on. I'm assuming that was some kind of test thing. I don't really know. I just flipped it back off so it won't do anything, but this was... well, you know what else? We never tightened that set screw up in there. We got to go back and... You're all in my picture, man. All in my picture, dude. But there's a set screw. Go over to the other side for a second. There's a set screw right there we've forgotten to tighten up. So I guess we can go ahead and tighten that up. I mean, we don't have the blade to put on it, but we can go ahead and do that. Maybe it'll quieten it up some. Got that tight, so that was a 1/8 Allen key. Key back on. It does some kind of little test cycle. It still is a little noisy, but... there's not a lot you can do about that. Still a little noisy. On low, it's fine. Just notice this up here on the controller, it's got a button up here that says blast. You press it, it shoots straight to 9 for like 2 seconds. So if you're going through like an intersection or something, you can press and hold. So if you're running on, let's say, a 3, you know, through a parking lot or something, you need that extra little boost. That's nice.
And I didn't think about it until just now. You pull that top pin out on the bottom side of, or the top side of the hitch, and then you can swing this thing down to get in and out of your tailgate that I didn't even realize that I completely forgot that I took that thing off. So that was good to realize, because that makes it nice. You just loosen that up and put your pin back in it, go on your road, and then if you need it back in your tailgate, you can angle that thing down like that by pulling the pin and shoot, jump in there and get your stuff out.
I'm just packing up my toolbox here with Charlie. Charlie's helping me get everything reorganized. And I had these floating around in the bottom. I'd actually put them in the door pocket and forgot about it. So I had to put them back in my little go box. Those are the Hart go boxes. My brother actually manufactures those tools, and so he gets discounts and stuff on them. He's always bringing home some kind of Hart stuff. They come from Walmart, and people hate on them because they're stupid cheap, but let me tell you, that has been a great little set just to have in the truck. It's got all the sockets, 1/2 inch, 3/8, 1/4. It's got Allen bits, a set of regular Allen wrenches, little pair of pliers, deep and short well. They're just chrome plates, chrome sockets, but they work really well for what they are. But what I was trying to tell you is these little guys right here, these are small little tire tools. Work great for motorcycles, lawnmowers, golf carts. They're not huge. They're really strong though. I had to buy these because I didn't bring a set with me. I was in Florida a few months ago and popped a tire on the motorcycle, and I tried screwdrivers. That was stupid. You can get these at most parts stores, AutoZones, O'Reilly's, NAPA's, stuff like that. They're less than like $15. I think I gave $11 for these or something. These are a must-have if you're doing a bunch of stuff like that.
I waited until it was cold and dark because I've got our new gear for the spreader, or gear, or whatever they call this thing. So let's open it up.
Let's see if I can do this without cutting my console all to pieces. That would be pretty cool. I cannot do that. So here's our new gear, and we see it does have the hole all the way through it like we need. And this one, see how flexible that is? Yeah, the other one didn't do that. So that pretty much looks the same. The other piece of it's inside, and I'm not going to get it, but this is from some super China place off the old Amazon. Did not come with a new pin. I'm pretty sure it advertised that it came with a new pin. Sucks, whatever. Let's put this thing on and see if it works. Oh man, I hate to be that guy, but that little cotter pin that was in the end of that thing, it whooped my ass. Finally got it out. So once you get that loose, go in here, right there. You've got that, 1/8. But you gotta loosen the little Torx or Allen. It's a set screw. Gotta loosen that guy up. And then the auger assembly right there. I wish we would have lifted it. Yep, straight up and out. And this has got to do like a couple things at once somehow or another. So it's going over that. So we're going to set it over the top of that. And then slide this whole thing down onto that shaft.
Well, got her installed. And that pin, like I said, was no good. Found a nail in a typical fashion. And that's on there. And then up underneath, the set screw is back in and tight. And if you want to know how I know that it's tight, there's the end of my 1/8 bit broken. Luckily I got it out. Having just enough Hart tools in the truck, and that one's got a little magnet on the tip of it, and I was able to wiggle it around until I got it free and came right out. So all of that's together now. No more missing pieces. We tested it. We know that it works. I know this is going to work because the motor does. Just to
run the controller up into the truck. I don't think I'm going to do that tonight. It's pretty chilly out here. And we've missed our mark for the day. So they got some snow and stuff overnight and throughout the day over near Banner Elk. Nothing's came down this way yet, but they're calling for some later this week, and maybe we'll get a chance to try it out then. But as of right now, we're still dry, but our spreader will be ready when that time does come. You thought that was the end of the video, but you were wrong. Finally found a different Tractor Supply that had one of them currently in stock, the 3300. These only go down to 5 degrees or so above zero. It's their lowest, as you can clearly see. But they're out of the 4300, which is what I was gonna buy. That one started to leak, so it's a good thing we're choosing this one. Go ahead and get it poured in. More sleep than anything is coming down right now. Let's see if we'll see this thing because it primes. There it goes. Alright, we'll be. Set it on a low speed. Oh yeah. That'll work perfect. Cycle. You can actually start running now.
Depends on what kind of speed and stuff, you know, you're running it through. I haven't ran it wide open yet, but pretty good. Controller's a little laggy, but it is a cheap unit, so not surprised there. Everything's melted right here. This is Jonas Ridge. Get another few inches tonight as that storm rolls in.
Well, boys and girls, I didn't follow up after the last couple clips that you saw. I didn't put an intro together for this video. I kind of forgot. Some time has passed by. We've ran about 250 pounds of salt through that spreader. It's not a lot so far. Everything's working pretty good. No complaints. They make a couple different auger bits that you can buy to put in it to change the amount of salt and stuff that is dispersed. I might try ordering one of the other ones. It works better for smaller granule salt, and depending on what you're using as a substitute. But for that larger stuff, like the 3300, it worked okay. That's big chunks of stuff as it is. So I'm pretty pleased with it. We're going to run it for the rest of this winter here and there. And, you know, maybe we'll do an end of winter video with it. And I'd like to get the Ford out, the Super Dexta, the Ford Sun, excuse me, Super Dexta out and maybe get some clips plowing or something, or pushing snow with it, I should say, weather permitting. So right now everything's kind of turned back into rain, and that's all it's going to do probably for another 5 or 6 days, unless you get up in the high elevations. So, but thank you all for watching. Drop a comment down below. Let us know what you think, and we'll catch you in the next one. Charlie's just out of frame over here, stuffing his face with food. Charlie. Doesn't even want to say bye. Oh, nope. All right, guys. Thank you for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.